People like you guys come in and ask me all the question, what been happening in the past? That's why the story I got it, I'm telling you guys today, and what been happening long ago.
My name is Benson Lingiari, came from Kaguragu, Body Creek Station. That means that I came down here to house all this following here about the land right. What I got story from my old father or grandpa, that land belonged to me, belonged to Aboriginal men before the horse and the cattle come over on that land, why I'm sitting there. Well, that's what I been keeping on my mind. Now, I still got it on my mind.
Oh, I'm glad I seen him when I was little. He's still around. He was a very humble man, very quiet in his own way. He was unique in his own way. Basically, the walk-off that took place 54 years ago this year, and he felt that he had enough being treated unfair, so he walked off the station. I'm proud to be called a Gurindji man, thanks to Lingiari and my mum and dad and our forefathers before us. They shaped Kalkaringi, they shaped the place we live in now, as well as Dangarogo. And just so proud of him and proud of his family and proud of me being here and being part of that history. He's opened up the gates for the land rights right across Australia. It means that we're living here today in our own community, doing our own things, being educated, living in a proper house. We've got good housing. So we've got to keep his legacy alive, because he's one of those old fellas, the 200 other men and women that walked off, made our life better and easier, and for our grandkids, you know, in the next generation coming. So I think Vincent Lingiari is one of those old fellas that should be up there with Nelson Mandela and Martin Luther King.
As a leader, I will always carry on what my people did, you know, especially Vincent Lingiari. I am so proud, you know, to be here in this land and sharing with my children, other kids, telling them the story, why we are here and why Freedom Day is being celebrated, you know.
Our opinion is he done all his best to us, and miss him in Apopaka. He's done all his best, and it's my brother-in-law who is married my elder sister. And that's why I was with him all the time, and he used to give me all that story, what he had. He used to pass it on to me.
Well, understanding that the people there, they was working for just the bread, tin, flour, tilip, and sugar. They sleep in a little humpy. We had no light. It's in a dark night. It's under a little rock. Sleep under the rock there. My family, when they started walk up from Jinbarak, they started walking back to the fence line. They got their swag, billy can, and a little bit of water. They came along, followed the fence along, got down to the real creek called Gordy Creek, Junani.
They should tell more people, get up, never do the work. They'd get rifle and shot him, you know? they're real cruel. They was real cheeky and come in and do that in Aboriginal country, you know? Yeah, Blackwell Creek there, we went out there and see all dead bodies, yeah, bone, everything what there. They taken a little bit of a hole and sucked a lot of rock on top and shot all the people there. And then never get away, no way. And they was trying to fight back with the spear, but they couldn't make it. Rifle too fast. More than 2,000 people. Biggest mob, kid, woman, old people. They were dying everywhere there. They digging a little bit of a hole and put all the stone on top there. They had to leave one block on top of the hill and watch it for all the men, white men coming up. They show him in the first block got shot at the block falling up there. Bang. And all them up out kind of run the Dagrago gorge, but they couldn't make it. Them block it, chased him with the horse, shot him out.
Children, young ones, old people were slaughtered. Very spiritual area. I'm very happy to take people out there. It's very sad, you know. But knowing the history of what we got needs to be heard. You can't keep being sorry about that.
I know I was told about the massacre sites. And the rangers, they still care, you know, I thank the rangers for what they're doing, you know. They're still keeping it alive, showing children. Then we've got our junior rangers, which will be taken over as they grow older. They're young now, but in about 20 or 15 years, they'll sort of take over.
This is the most important area in our history of our human history as well, with our families were massacred out here. Kids were grabbed on legs and smashed on rocks and buried in shallow graves out here. And stories never been told like this from our people. It breaks my heart today just to see people I'm here talking about now. Should have happened before. But makes you really sad today. As human, kids were just grabbed on a leg, on foot, and smashed on rocks. Adults were shot with one bullet each. And they were buried out here, in this grave here, in the shallow grave, and another one over there. And these stories should be told to future generations to learn from what our people went through and to learn from there.
Well, you told us after all my workers, not what we're working with, Vestey don't giving us fair go, not pay us after what we get back in the station. They should pay us what we've done all our best for them. And they didn't do it for us. That's real cheeky, you know? And that's why old Bingen made up his mind. He said, well, we don't want to work with them. We've done all our best for them and they don't give us a fair go. Or we might walk out from a Wavell station, and we did.
Thank you.
survival, survival after struggle, rights for our people, bravery because of Vincent and Gary, you know, against all odds, they actually achieved something.
I solemnly hand to you these deeds as proof in Australian law that these lands belong to the Gurindji people.
It's for us because we're a proud nation, Gurindji people, but it's to share with everybody and everybody to know what we have to give, you know, and yeah. Share with others.
Well, Freedom Day is to celebrate culturally, politically, celebration of the life of Vincent and Gary and those 200 men and women that walked off. It's to keep our culture alive. Freedom Day means to me that you know, we share our knowledge and share our culture with the rest of Australia, the rest of the Indigenous people of Australia, and. I'd like to continue keeping up his legacy because it shouldn't just stop. That's the history of Australia, history of the Northern Territory, and history of all Indigenous society right across the nation. The younger ones, you know, always lead up with the march. We can actually celebrate. We can actually do that walk across the Victoria River. In honour of those old men and women and Vincent and Gary, celebrating Freedom Day, and the mixed emotion of proud happiness just fills the air with enjoyment. The history of the story of what took place here should be out there, you know. And people should be talking about it with pride because, you know, I'm sitting down here right now on the grounds of the birthplace of land rights, and that should spread right across the nation.
Well, it's important because of my great-grandfather. He started it off. We get to celebrate it everyone once a year for 3 days. I get happy that we're celebrating it. Sort of emotional for me without him here.
From little things, big things grow. Over the years, we have grown from little thing because thanks to Vincent and Gary, when he walked off, the longest strike history in Australia, probably the world. So from little things, big things grow. I think that comes from a lyric, from a song from Kev Carmody and Paul Kelly. Amazing artists, amazing people. I met them and they're just both incredible. And we thank them. You know, the Gurindji people actually thank them from the bottom of our hearts for writing something so powerful and effective. It's based on the history of this place with Vincent Lingiari, when they settled at Waddy Creek and waited so many years until it was recognised and the land was given back to Lingiari from the Honourable late Gough Whitlam. So the song, you know, it just tells it all, and we now look at that song, and you know, we take it into our heart, and it's the national anthem of Kalkaringi and Dagorago.
Well, that was the story of Vincent Lingiari, but this is the story of something much more. How power and privilege can unmove a people who know where they stand. Stand in the law. From little things, big things grow. From little things, big things grow. From little things, big things grow. From little things, big things grow from